Hi, I'm Gary Eckstein from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. I'm getting a lot of questions at the moment about how to add images and logos in the new Mailchimp email builder. So I thought I'd create a quick video about this. What I'm talking about here is if we go to create an email in the new email builder in Mailchimp, and if I go to content, if I click edit and content, for example, we'll see in a second that I'm in the new email builder. So the questions I'm getting are really, how do we add images from our content studio or just images in general into an image block? And also, how do we add a logo? Let's deal with a logo first of all. If I click on logo, I can immediately set my logo. Now, Mailchimp, I'm sure, will update this, so you might not still have this problem issue when you watch this, but for now, it exists. So if I click Set Logo, what you'll notice is I don't go into my Content Studio where images are typically kept in Mailchimp. It asks me to upload an image. What I prefer to do in this case is actually just use an image here, and I'll get into how to add an actual image in a second. But to add an image instead of the logo, and remember logos are typically just an image anyway, I just click the plus sign, click image. There we go. And then I can just delete the existing logo block by clicking anywhere in the block, not exactly on the logo itself, but anywhere in the block, and clicking the little rubbish bin or bin icon. Okay. So to add an image anywhere, whether it's there, whether it's at the top, whether it's underneath here, all we do in the new email builder is we click in the block. Then to the left-hand side, you'll notice that we can click add and we can either select image, which means go to the content studio, which I'll show in a second, or we could upload an image from our local computer. But if I click select image, I immediately go to the good old Content Studio, which you'll be familiar with from the old email builder. I can choose any image I want to. So for example, I could just click my logo here, click insert, and you'll notice that it automatically adds it. So that's how easy it is to use the Content Studio to add my image in this case, or any image I want to. Of course, what's a great idea is for your images, add a hyperlink. So that if people do click on your image, or image or logo for that matter, they go to your website, for example. Alt text as well. Get in the habit of always inserting alt text. It's just a few words that describe the image. This is usually used for in two instances. If people are using screen readers, it'll talk what the image is about in that case, what you put in the alt text. And also, it's important because if images don't load for people, you send them an email, images don't load for them, at least they'll see the text if you do have alt text. Now, keep in mind, of course, just on that specific matter, that if we do send an email to people and images don't load for them, there's nothing we as the sender can do to force them to load those images. It's a setting on the recipient side, whether to show images or not. But anyway, hope this has helped. Please like this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.